Thank you. I'll be your MC for tonight's ceremonies, along with Paul Hussey. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2018 East Northumberland Secondary School graduation. Would you please stand for the academic procession?
Thank you.
on tonight by our graduating members of our beloved Raspy Jazz vocal group, conducted by Linda Thompson.
Tonight is a special night for our graduates, This is a true celebration of their efforts here at ENSS. And therefore, we ask that parents and guests please feel free to take pictures anytime the ceremony by coming forward to our photo area just in front of where the graduates are waiting for.
We would now like to call upon Cindy Dixon, our local trustee, to bring her greetings to the graduates.
Good evening and welcome.
Life will inspire you, and life will also disappoint you. but the story of your life is written by you. If I could leave each of you with just one piece of wisdom, it would be that many cliches about the future tend to be true. Things like when one door closes, another one opens, a penny saved is a penny earned, and actions speak louder than words. I sincerely hope that each of you finds the place in the world that you want to be. Thank you and congratulations.
We'd like to invite Mark Wallace, our Mayor of Brighton, to bring greetings from the Municipality of Brighton.
My goodness, what I first can say from standing here, looking out at this wonderful crowd, what a great day for the Municipality of Brighton. It's awfully quiet for a school, but we have some dragons in the house. I asked if we had any dragons in the house. Welcome and good evening. Principal Phillip, distinguished guests, faculty and staff, ladies and gentlemen, graduates. It is an honor and a pleasure to have been invited here again this year to participate in the East Northumberland Secondary School 2018 graduation ceremony. Principal Phillip, faculty and staff, your continued leadership and commitment to this school has been greatly appreciated by the students, this council, and the greater community. And for that, we say thank you. To the parents, for your support, understanding, and patience, offer these young men and women here tonight the opportunity to face the challenges ahead with a strong and solid foundation. And finally, to the graduates, you have been given the tools to better your own lives and to better the lives of those around you. Your community will continue to support you in your efforts. On behalf of myself and members of council, to the graduating class of 2018, we wish you the success in the future and congratulate all of you on your achievements. Now I'll ask Kelly Towers, Chair of School Council, to bring greetings from School Council.
Welcome parents, guardians, family members, and this year's graduating class. On behalf of Parent Council, I want to congratulate the students and parents sitting here this evening. I also want to take a moment to acknowledge that the process to reach this achievement has been different for every student sitting here tonight. For some students, the tests and assignments came easily. You may have been on the honor roll and cheer, and the social aspect of school was a breeze. For some students, reaching this milestone was more challenging. It may have taken longer than 4 years, and it may have felt like you were working way harder than 4 years. For some parents sitting here tonight, the last 4 years have flown by, and for others, you may have thought the day would never come. No matter what the journey looked like, each and every one of you should be proud of your accomplishments. Proud that you persevered and did not give up. Parents, you found a way to encourage and support your child, foster responsibility while holding the child accountable. Students, you were able to balance school, work, social life, find value in your education, and finish what you started. These are valuable character traits that will take you far in life. So graduates, let your parents take a million pictures and tag you on Facebook. Maybe they're kind of cool and have Instagram. Regardless, they're so incredibly proud of you. And they're just trying to freeze time and preserve these proud moments. On behalf of the ENSS Parent Council, congratulations graduating class and parents of 2018.
We would now ask Charlotte Phillip, Principal of ENSS, to deliver the principal's message.
To begin, I would like to recognize that we are gathering on the traditional territory of the Mississauga First Nation. Good evening, honored guests, parents, guardians, family members, and most importantly, our distinguished students of ENSS. My name is Charlotte Phillip, and I have the proud honor of being the principal at our fine school. Welcome. We gather here this evening to honor the class of 2018. This marks an important transition for the young men and women assembled here. The diplomas our graduates receive recognize and celebrate their years of hard work, commitment, dedication, and achievement. Tonight is a milestone in their lives, and we are proud of their accomplishments. It's a great honor for me to be here with you this evening. 4 years ago, most of our grads joined us as with their band leaders as a group of fidgety grade nines, both excited and scared as they entered the huge world of high school. Now here they are, sitting together for the last time as the graduating class of 2018. This group of senior students have worked together in so many ways to make a difference for our school and for our community. Now they're going off and making their own path and joining the ranks of the ENSS alumni who proudly carry on the tradition of excellence that is the heart and soul of this school. As I look out into this auditorium, I see parents, guardians, family members, and friends. You are the support team. Congratulations and well done. Being a parent is not an easy task, and while we are here to celebrate the success of our children, none of this would be possible without the unconditional love that you provide. As parents and caregivers, the one thing we want most for our kids is to ensure their highest well-being. And we have sacrificed in many ways to ensure that our children have opportunities for success and opportunities to be the best that they can be. High school graduation is a monumental point in time for parents. Who would have thought that 17 or 18 years ago, you would be here this evening? Where has the time gone? Our children sit here as young adults, moving forward into the world that looks much different from the one that we graduated into. At commencement, we must also recognize the efforts of our teaching and support staff at ENSS. They are superb professionals who work very hard to provide a safe environment and the best learning opportunities for our students. They put in countless hours, work diligently to meet the needs of all learners, and hold themselves to the highest academic standards. The staff at ENSS care about our kids, they care about our school, and they care about this community. They are part of the memories that our grads will take with them. They have made a difference in the lives of your children, and they deserve a round of applause of appreciation and thanks. We also wish the best for some very special staff members who are retiring this June, Ms. Payette, Mr. Kushnick, and Ms. Vanderburg, who retired in January. Their commitment to ENSS and to the education profession has been exceptional. We thank them for what they have done for our ENSS community and wish them all the best in a well-deserved retirement. To the class of 2018, I thought long and hard about the words of wisdom that I pass along to you tonight. You are about to enter what some people may call real life. That might be college, university, or the world of work. In high school, we're always talking to you about the real world and how we need to prepare you for the challenges that lie ahead. The funny thing about life is that there's no longer learning goals written on the board and success criteria to guide you. Learning becomes more difficult to quantify, and most real-life tests are truly unannounced, especially those tests that involve your character, your values, and the understanding of those around you. And graduates, remember when you thought your parents didn't know anything about anything? Watch how incredibly smart they will become over the next 15 years or so. It turns out that your parents are pretty skilled at picking up on real-life lessons, usually because they've been there themselves and they understand what you're going through. Continue to talk with and listen to your folks. They have learned from their mistakes and may save you some stress and anxiety along the road of life. And graduates, as you move into the next stage, remember the golden rule. What you put out is coming back to you all the time. It's science, simple science. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. So let's keep it simple. Graduates, be humble, work hard, and most importantly, be kind. Think about your intentions in all that you do, as they have an impact on those around you. I have been to ENSS graduations here in Upper Lake many times, once as a student, and I sat where you are, 3 times as a vice principal, and 2 times as a principal. Now, like our graduates, I am also moving on to another chapter and another principal position. However, I have been truly impacted by the continued success and pride that I see in our school. ENSS is one of the most successful schools I have ever been at. I often wonder if everyone really sees this, because it continues to be the norm year after year. Academics, science fairs, athletics, community activities, school spirit, not to mention Terry Fox. No one else can raise $42,000 in 1 year for cancer research. And it just does not happen anywhere else, but it happens here. Over the years, the last two, I've accumulated 18 ENSS t-shirts, hats, and sweatshirts. I actually counted them the other day. At ENSS, staff and students wear our school clothing with pride, and so does the whole community. So graduates, continue to wear yours, and always remember where you came from. ENSS is an amazing school, and you have contributed to its success. So as you sit together as a class for this one last time, I encourage you to dream big. Dreams will help you do great things. Continue to learn. Don't be afraid to step outside of your comfort zone. Take responsibility for your successes and responsibility for your failures. Don't give up. I hope your time at ENSS has been fulfilling and rewarding. Class of 2018, on behalf of the administration and the staff of ENSS, we wish you the greatest success and best of luck. And don't forget, once a blue dragon, always a blue dragon.
Thank you. At this time, could we ask Julia Lawrence, our 2018-2019 Student Government Prime Minister, to bring greetings from Student Government.
Hello, staff, guests, friends and family, and of course, a reason to gather here today in graduating class of 2018. My name is Julia Lawrence, and I will be next year's Prime Minister. And I wish you all the best of luck in your future, and I have no doubt you will make ENSS proud. For those who will be joining us again next year, let's make it a good one. And on behalf of the student government, we wish you the best of luck, and we hope you do well. Now enjoy the rest of your evening.
Distinguished guests, as you've said already, my name is Paul Hussey, and I'm very proud drama teacher here at ENSS, and I have been given the honor and the privilege to introduce this year's valedictorian. I have known this young man for many years, as we were once neighbors on the same street, and to see the fine young man he has become today certainly brings a big smile to my face. As like years in the past, this year's valedictorian has been hand-selected through a voting process by their classmates. Year in and year out, ENSS is stock-filled with outstanding individuals, individuals that certainly could have been acclaimed valedictorian. This graduating class is no exception. Therefore, I can think of no bigger honor than to be recognized by my peers, especially considering those in the running this year. This young man is an outstanding and well-rounded student who embodies our school's motto of tradition, excellence, and heart. He is a dedicated individual who is fully committed to both his academics and his extracurricular activities. This young man has a unique character and energy about him, and I believe it is safe to say that he had some challenges early at ENSS, but showed amazing resilience, and with the love and help of many friends and family, he stands before you tonight. He represents talent, integrity, creativity, and passion. And I wish him the best of luck in everything he does in the future, especially as he pursues a career in film at the University of Ryerson. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce this year's valedictorian for 2018, Mr. Ben Hughes.
really sweating here, so like, I'm all sticky and it's really uncomfortable, but I'm doing it. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Benjamin Hughes, your valedictorian. I have been given the honor and the privilege to speak to you all tonight, and it's such a tremendous and special honor. I have so many words to speak, but I have such little time to say them. I look out and I see such familiar faces that have altered my life. The years here have provided us with stepping stones to our future. Initially, we were baby blue dragons in a world of large and hairy dragons. It was a scary moment for us, but with BAM and so much blue dragon spirit, it felt like home. Throughout our years at ENSS, we have taken a part in our $1 million mark for fundraising at Terry Fox Foundation. We've taken part and participated in the first year of the Dragon Roses, and we have witnessed, taken part in, and performed in various dances, parties, musicals, sports teams, and field trips. But what will be remembered most throughout these years will be our friends. School here was not just a place of learning and development. It was a place of family, a second home for all of us. The friends that we've made here, teachers, students, will all remember us through the beauty and magic of the events at the school. But eventually, there is an end to all good things. We say goodbye to our second home. Friends will be going to other universities and colleges. Teachers will be moving on with other classes and will become independent for possibly the first time. And having said that, friendships are forever. They are the roots to the tree, shaping how we grow and keeping us whole. And although your best buddy may be going to Ottawa or British Columbia, they will always remember you, and you will never forget the events that have taken place here at the school. Now, here's the thing. I'm going to quote Toy Story for a little bit. Now, which is beyond the doubt, like one of the saddest and most important forms of our childhood, and never fails to make me cry. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead, and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said. You've got a friend in me. Saying goodbye is, without a doubt, the hardest part of our lives. But in life, the world is filled with many goodbyes and many hellos, but always memory. Yes, we have in your books and photographs, but it does not tell the full story. It is the moments when you had a crush, when you made a friend, had awkward presentations, or failed a test. The truest forms, they came from within. And these are through the smiles we shared with our friends. And just on your other side, students, they're the people who've been through it all. When you look at them, there's not a shred of disappointment, only happiness. Your family will always be by your side. They are your guardian in this wide world. And for the teachers, they have brought us from the little grade nines that we once were and have transformed us into adults. They have shown us our road to happiness and exposed the passions that were inside of us. Teachers, without you, we would not have felt at home. And although we are leaving and we are no longer your students, you have made an everlasting impression in our hearts. Thanks for all the memories of friendship. ENSS is a second family, and although there may be some who might not think that, just realize that it's because of the school that these special bonds were created. But now it's the time when the birds leave its nest and take its first flight. Time of joy and sorrow. This will be the last assembly for us, and the last time we can call ourselves students of ENSS. Because after today, we strive towards our future. The real world is calling our doctors, lawyers, scientists, actors, and mathematicians. The universe is waiting for all of us. It's time that we show the world what a true blue dragon really is. I'll leave you with another quote from a man who is best recognized from the hum of your father's voice, or perhaps from the thumping of your mother's heart when you're just a child. He's a man who has shaped our lives and of whom has encompassed our views in children's literature. Sometimes you will never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory. Was Dr. Seuss. We are ready to start our lives and become who we really are. Thank you, East Northern Secondary School, for all that you have done, for the lives of your students, and to the friends, thank you for all the love and support throughout the years. Time can only tell how much fun we will have in the coming future. And to our parents and family, thank you for always believing in us. And without you, our lives wouldn't be whole. Although it may seem we are leaving home and we are separating our lives from you, well, you will always be your children. You will always have a home with us, just as we will always have a home. Congratulations to the Dragons, class of 2018. Yeah. Thanks.
Thank you, Ben. We will be calling Ben back to the stage after the diploma ceremony to properly thank him and allow him to lead the graduating class in a celebratory cap toss.
At this time, we would like to begin the presentation of diplomas, certificates, awards, and scholarships. All of the 2018 graduating class will receive their diplomas, certificates, awards, and scholarships first. Then we will be awarding any former graduated students who return for an extra year.
Now, some of our graduates have decided to share with us their post-secondary destinations, and we want to be very clear that we are proud of all of the graduates, whether entering university, college, apprenticeship, or the workforce. At this time, we highly encourage parents to move forward to collect those valuable pictures just in this open area here. And we are encouraging all graduates, there is a green X on our stage, and that's where the photo op will happen.
Would Charlotte, Philip, and Kim Leger please come forward to present the first set of diplomas and certificates?
Award to be awarded by Linda Tompkins.
to the music program at ENSS. She is also awarded the Loyalist College Entrance Scholarship. This will be presented by Crystal Barrow. This is awarded to a student who has earned a minimum of 85% and has accepted an offer of admission to Loyalist College.
Margaret Barnes, Ontario Scholar, Specialist High School's major in the environment. Margaret is attending Queen's University in the fall to study engineering.
Margaret is the winner of two awards tonight. The first is the Student Equity Award presented by Craig Petter, awarded to a graduating student who best exemplifies equality by taking measures to prevent bullying and promote inclusion within the student body. Margaret is also the recipient of the ENSS Staff Scholarship presented by Crystal Wallero, awarded to a graduating student with a high average and proceeding to either university or college. Congratulations, Margaret.
Shannon Barrett, Ontario Scholar. Shannon is going to St. Lawrence College in Kingston for a Community and Justice Services program. She would like to become a correctional officer.
The Cranston Community Policing Award to be presented by Darlene Davison. This is awarded to a student residing in Cranby Township who is furthering their education in the field of policing.
Noah Berry, Ontario Scholar. Noah is studying engineering at Queen's University.
Noah is the recipient of an award tonight, the Ross Pinkerton Award, presented by Charlotte Phillip, awarded to a deserving student living in Northumberland County, proceeding to post-secondary education. Congratulations, Noah.
Shane Perry. Shane is off to Trent University for Business Administration with a specialization in accounting.
Thank you.
Noah Bauer. Natasha Bowman. Natasha is on St. Louis College for the pre-health program. Tyson Remen.
Joshua Jarrell, presented by Linda Wallace and Jane Jarrell. Josh is a former student of ENSS, and this bursary is awarded to a student pursuing a post-secondary career in the field of heavy equipment techniques or automotive mechanics, and shows a real interest and passion for their chosen field. Congratulations.
And next speaker, Andrea Stoller, who is off to Trump University for the Honors Arts Program in Forensic Science.
Thank you for the recipient of all of us tonight, the Colburn Rotary Club Board Positive Memorial Bursary, to be presented by Glenn Spence. This is awarded to a student who resides in Harry Township.
Thank you.
Colton Cridland, Ontario Scholar.
Paul is the recipient of two awards tonight. The first is the Covington Women's Institute Award to be presented by Debbie Dupuis. This is awarded to a graduating student who resides in the Institute's district who is proceeding to a post-secondary education. The second award is the Ross Pickerington Award to be presented by Charlotte Phillip, awarded to a deserving student living in Northumberland County proceeding to a post-secondary education.
Sarah Croft. Sarah is taking a year off to work and then going to St. Lawrence for vet tech. Allison Deans, Ontario Scholar. Allison will be taking a year off to work. Brooke DeBruin. Brooke will be returning to ENSS and also taking some time off to work before going to college. She's currently working towards her specialist high school major.
The Drama Award will be presented by Paul Hussey. Awarded to a graduating student who has been involved in several major productions, achieved high marks, and who has shown talent, enthusiasm, and cooperation in the drama program. The ENSS Stage Production Award, also to be awarded by Paul Hussey, is awarded to a student who has been involved in several productions and has shown talent, enthusiasm, and cooperation. The Luminaldi MPP Award for Leadership is awarded to a student proceeding to a post-secondary education who has shown qualities of leadership, reliability, cooperation, dependability, achievement, and who has taken an active part in school government and or extracurricular activities, as well as the community, to be presented by Nora Christos. Good thing she knew that.
The University of Toronto National Book Award will also be presented by Nora Christos. This is awarded to a graduating student proceeding to a university program who is being recognized for exceptional ability, achievement, extracurricular involvement, and leadership in the eyes of the school and the University of Toronto. In addition, Lauren has already won and received the CIBC Bursary, which is awarded to a student who showed academic promise and participated in extracurricular activities. Congratulations, Lauren.
And thank you, Lauren. And it was all the her call is welcome to the
Nadia is the winner of a couple of awards tonight. The first is the Brighton Legion Music Proficiency Trophy, presented by Strina Chalmers. Awarded to a graduating student with the highest marks in senior music with characteristics of dedication, loyalty, and exceptional musical ability. And lastly, Nadia is also the recipient of the Ross Pinkerton Award, presented by Charlotte Phillip, awarded to a deserving student living in Northumberland County proceeding to post-secondary education. Congratulations, Nadia.
Jamie Dolmage, Ontario Scholar.
Haley is also the winner of an award tonight. She is the recipient of the Suzanne Kernighan Education Bursary, presented by Charlotte Phillip. Awarded to a student who is a resident of Granby Township, a minimum of 70% average, and is pursuing a career in the field of child and youth worker. Congratulations.
Mason Dunk, specialist high skills major in the environment. Mason is going to work. He has also been enrolled in the Canadian military. Robert Duvall. Robert is returning to ENSS for one semester and will go on to Lewis College for nursing. Spencer, specialist high school major in arts and culture. Brandon will be renting in Ottawa and attending Carleton University for architecture.
At this time, our two vice principals, Lisa Hickman and Vicki Dunn, please come forward to present the next set of diplomas and certificates.
Curtis Farrow. Curtis Farrow is a specialist high school engineer. Curtis is off to Royals College to study welding and fabrication. He also hopes to study giraffes in Africa. Jonathan Fawcett. Jonathan Fawcett is an Ontario scholar. He is off to Queen's University to study engineering. He is considering a focus in mechanical engineering.
John is the recipient of 6 awards tonight. The Claude Thompson Mathematics Award will be presented by Kelly Arnwood. This is awarded to a graduating student with the highest average in 3 4U mathematics courses accumulated over 1 or more years. The Baxter Scholarship for Science. This will be presented by Colin Jago. It's awarded to a graduating student with the highest mark in 4U physics received in the senior years. John will also receive received a Prix de Compétence en Légion Tardive, pardon my French, to be presented by Rebecca Turner, awarded to the student with the highest mark in extended French, FEF 4UL. Donna will also receive the Bright and Lions Senior Science Award, which will be presented by Estrida Chalmers. It's awarded to a graduating student with the highest combined average in chemistry and biology taken in one or more years. This is a great quality course. In addition, John has already won and received the prestigious Chernoff Award. This award is given to an individual with a combination of superior academic ability, creative thinking, and proven leadership. This award could fully fund one's education. And John has also won and will receive later this evening the prestigious Governor General's Award for the highest average.
She is also the recipient of the Frederick Hennessy Foundation Bursary presented by Brooke Pemberton.
Nice,
this
DJ!
This bursary is awarded to a deserving graduating student with a minimum average of 75% who is proceeding to post-secondary institution. Congratulations.
Good job, DJ! So proud of you, sweetheart! Good job, sweetheart. I love
Happy
you.
Happy tears, kiddo.
Janet is going to Loyola's College in the Pre-Health Program, and then into a four-year nursing program at Loyola's College in Brock University. Lucas Gomez. Lucas is an Ontario scholar, and he has studied computer science at the University of Toronto, St. George Thomas.
The recipient of one award tonight, the Ross Pinkerton Award to be presented by Charlotte Phillip. This is awarded to a deserving student living in Northumberland County proceeding to post-secondary education. Congratulations.
Emily Green. Emily will be studying at Rollins College in September. Engineering.
Treanor is the recipient of an award tonight, the Northumberland County Warden's Award, presented by Mark Wallace, awarded to a graduating student receiving a full-time post-secondary education who has combined outstanding marks in extracurricular and or involvement. Congratulations.
Cameron Bryans. Cameron is a specialist high schools major in hospitality and tourism. Cameron will be going to Fleming College in 2019 for their culinary management program. Jacob Brown. Jacob will be studying at Foundation of Wellness College in
Ohio. Jacob is the recipient of an award tonight. The Brighton Rotary Club Service Above Self Award for Business to be presented by Mark Wallace. This is awarded to a graduating student from the business program who is continuing his education through apprenticeship, college, or university.
Wait.
Jessica Hansen. Jessica is taking a year off and will then be attending Loyalist College to study baking. Daniel Herlacher. Daniel intends on returning to the fifth year study. Christian Herlacher.
Contribution to physical education both in the class and in extracurricular activities, who is proceeding to a career in physical education or some other recreational field. The second award he will be receiving is the Clay Elliott Scholarship Foundation Award to be presented by Anne Fowle. Submission of an essay. The award is primarily based on the applicant's response to the essay question, demonstrating that they possess the right kind of attitude to succeed in future endeavors. Congratulations.
Cal Hightower. Cal is a specialist high school major in construction, and he will be working for JCK Construction in the fall.
In addition, she has received the ENSS Stage Production Award to be presented by Paul Hussey, awarded to a student who has been involved in several productions and has shown talent, enthusiasm, and cooperation. Congratulations, Emma.
Hunter is home. Hunter is taking the year off. Benjamin Hughes. Benjamin is an Ontario scholar and attended the Ryerson University in the fall to study image arts and film studies.
Ben is the recipient of 5 awards tonight. The first is the Socratic Prize to be awarded by Derek Cunningham. It's awarded to the student with the highest final mark in grade 12 university philosophy or the most outstanding philosophy term paper. The second award is the Drama Award to be awarded by Paul Hussey. The Drama Award is awarded to a graduating student who has been involved in several major productions, achieved high marks, and has shown talent, enthusiasm, and cooperation in the drama program. In addition, Mr. Hussey will present the Northumberland Players Youth Award, awarded to a graduating or graduated student who has contributed to the drama program and is proceeding to a post-secondary institution in the drama field. In addition, he's honored to receive the Justin House Memorial Award to be presented by Sharon Powell and Henry House. This prestigious award is granted to a graduating student with average of over 75% who has a strong commitment to the arts, gets along exceptionally well with others, is responsible, has a sense of humor, and helps peers in a friendly manner. Ben has already won, will be receiving shortly, the Marie Dressler Foundation Award, which is awarded to a student from Northumberland County who is pursuing further education in performing arts and visual arts. Congratulations.
Michaela Davidson. Michaela is a specialist high skills major in environmental studies. Michaela will be going to St. Lawrence College in the fall to become a veterinary technician. Kurt Hicksmeyer. Kurt is an Ontario scholar and Kurt will be returning to ENSS for a fifth year of studies.
Science.
Let's go
on.
Kaylee Jenkins. Kaylee is taking a year off to work. Aviation Operations Program. Matthew Jastrow. Matthew is headed to Plains Lincoln campus in January for the Heavy Equipment Technician Program.
Thank you.
Abby Cover. Abby is an Ontario scholar. Abby will be pursuing a Bachelor of Science in Financial Mathematics at Ryerson University in Toronto.
Abby is the winner of two awards tonight. The first is the Colburn Masonic United Lodge No. 91 Scholarship, presented by Rick Richmond. Awarded to a graduating student going on to post-secondary education who resides in Cranley Township, and who has demonstrated outstanding character in school-sponsored volunteer activities and demonstrated a willingness to unselfishly assist others. Abby also received the Brenton ENSS Leo Club Scholarship, presented by Astrid Chalmers, awarded to a student continuing to post-secondary education who has been a member of the Leo's Club for multiple years and has demonstrated leadership, commitment, and service to their school and their community. Congratulations.
Callum Coots. Callum is an Ontario scholar and is off to Carleton University to study accounting.
The Amanda James Memorial Award for Math, which will be presented by Amber James. This award is granted to a graduating or graduated student who has successfully completed either the senior dance, math, or English classes. Would Nancy Wilson or Deanne Patnall please come forward to present the next set of diplomas and certificates?
Jean Lalonde. Jean is going to turn the call to become a medical assistant. Katie Larry, Ontario Scholar. Katie will be studying kinesiology at the University of Western Ontario.
Katie is the winner of an award tonight. She is the winner of the Offset Track and Field Legacy Scholarship Award presented by Julie Lang, awarded to a deserving student athlete who has competed in track and field at Bay of Quinte. Congratulations.
Nicholas Lawrence. Nick will be back to ENSS for a fifth year. Jonas Lalonde, Ontario Scholar. Jonas is going to the Rose College to study electrical engineering and potentially automation.
Jonas is the recipient of one award tonight. He receives the W.M. Sprung Award to be presented by Colin Jago. This is awarded to a graduating student with the highest combined average in mathematics MCT 4C1 and physics MSPH 4C1 accumulated over one or more years.
William McClure, Specialist High School Union for Transportation. Taylor Lee, Ontario Scholar. Taylor is at Queen's University, where she says she will likely be done by the retirement club South Florida.
Taylor is the winner of three awards today. The first award is the Kim Rudd Award, presented by Elizabeth Edward, awarded to a graduating student proceeding to post-secondary education. They have gone beyond the diploma requirements for community service to enhance the life of their school or community. St. Alphonsus CWL Citizenship Award presented by Margaret Remuen, awarded to a graduating student who has been involved in community, demonstrates concern for others, and expresses high team spirit. And lastly, she is the recipient of the Ross Pickerton Award presented by Charlotte Phillip, awarded to a deserving student living in Northumberland County proceeding to post-secondary education. Congratulations.
Eric Lind, Ontario Scholar. Yeah.
College for General Arts and Science.
Sean Nicole. Sean's taking it. Hannah McCurry will be attending Loyola's College to become a biotechnologist. Austin McDonald. Austin is going to the University of Ottawa for an honors bachelor of social sciences and political science. Casey McCullough, specialist high school major in honors biology. Mrs. Payne is a state farmer and a journalist. Erica McLaren.
Thank you.
Andrew Underwood, and Charles Scholar. In the fall, Andrew will be studying computer science at the ULIT.
Okay, I'm filming.
Elena Nadeau, Ontario Scholar. And then we'll be attending St. Lawrence College in the fall for the program of the Academy of Teaching. Caitlin Nadeau. Caitlin is going to Seneca College in Markham for the 2-year flight services program starting in May of 2019.
Award to be presented by Richard Belzewski. This is an award given to a graduating student who has displayed qualities of reliability, cooperation, dependability, achievement, and extra effort. Congratulations.
Chantal Odette. Chantal is studying at
this time, would Crystal Barrow and Craig Petherick please come forward to present the final set of diplomas and certificates.
Mercedes Parnell Robinson. Mercedes is our
good job, baby.
Cora Patterson. Cora is an Ontario scholar. In the fall, Cora is heading to Bishop University for a Bachelor of Business Administration. She intends to major in accounting.
Cora is the winner of the Doris Bowes Memorial Bursary presented by Kelly Northbrook, awarded to a graduating student who is proceeding to full-time attend a college or university in either accounting or business. Congratulations.
Carly Payne. Carly is an Ontario scholar who is going to St. John's College in Kingston to study her child and youth work abroad.
Carly is also the recipient of two awards tonight. She's the recipient of the You Are the World Bursary to be presented by Jim Reed, father of Aaron Reed. It's awarded to a graduating student pursuing a post-secondary career in the field of child and youth worker. This bursary is in memory of Aaron Reed. She's also receiving the Amanda James Memorial Award for dance to be presented by Amber James. It's awarded to a graduating or graduated student who has successfully completed either the senior dance, math, or English classes. Congratulations.
Grace Valerie Cole. Grace is heading to Kingston to study veterinary technology at St. Lawrence College.
Grace is the recipient of the Senior Science Award presented by Lynn Weirda. Lynn is a graduating student who performed well in 4C and/or 3C chemistry and bio, I think. Must be proceeding to post-secondary education in the fall. Well done.
Emily Pilcher. Emily will be attending St. Lawrence College to study behavioral science.
Congratulations.
Cooper Reed. Cooper is an Ontario scholar who has studied criminal medicine at the University of Toronto.
Cooper is the recipient of two awards tonight. The first is the Presqu'ile Yacht Club Scholarship presented by Colin Jago, awarded to a deserving graduating student who resides in Gosford and is proceeding to a post-secondary institution. His second award is the Northumberland Paramedic Award presented by Marcel Johnson, Colby Bass, and Tasha Haber, awarded to a student who has been accepted into a paramedic program. Congratulations.
Liliana Reed. Lily will be teaching at Premier Events in Portland. Bradley Jenkins Robin. Bradley is in the Bradley is going to be in the workplace and have the automotive cartridge returns. Benjamin Scar Crosby's. Penny has returned to GNSS for one year. Matthew Scar Crosby's. Michael Scar Crosby's. And Nicholas Scott Crosby.
Graduating student who has shown great improvement. Congratulations. Woo!
Jessica Sanger. Jessica is going to Loyola's College to study social services. Stephanie Shapiro. Stephanie is an Ontario scholar and has offered work to the University to study economics.
Stephanie is the recipient of the award tonight. The Bright and Grand Chamber of Commerce Award will be presented by Paul Hussey. It's awarded to a student with a high academic average proceeding to a college or university in either business, hospitality, or tourism.
Pictures. Oh, too fast. There we go. Thank you. Thanks.
Devin Shaw. Devin is taking the year off to stay home from home.
Devin is the recipient of the ENSS Staff Scholarship presented by Crystal Lauderdale, awarded to a graduating student with a great attitude and or high average proceeding to university, college, or the workforce. Congratulations, Devin.
Thank you.
Award tonight. He's one of the recipients of the Barbara Ann Jarvis Foundation Award to be presented by Eva Ward and Holly Ward. This prestigious award fully funds a graduating student enrolled in full-time post-secondary.
Isaac Snyder. Isaac is an honorary scholar and is headed to Laurentian University for health promotions in connection with concurrent education program. Montana Spratt. Montana is attending Loyola's College in the fall to study pre-health. J.C. Steves. J.C. is an Ontario's college and is living in Kingston to study commerce at Queen's University. Olivia Stevenson. Olivia is going to the Royals College for the Development of Service Grader Program.
Olivia is the winner of the Community Living Campbellford Writing Award presented by Ann Simpson, awarded to a graduating student proceeding to a Developmental Services Worker Program. Well done, Olivia.
Michaela Stoneman. Michaela is an Ontario scholar who is going to the Royal Military College to study engineering. Gina Strong. Gina is an Ontario scholar and is pursuing a Bachelor of Commerce with Cooperative Education at Carleton University.
By Linda Tompkin. It's awarded to a graduating or graduated student who is involved in music or the arts and is pursuing post-secondary education. Congratulations.
Brayden Taylor. Brayden is an Ontario scholar and a special Lauren Taylor. Lauren is an Ontario scholar and will be attending the University of Victoria. She has accepted a spot in the Faculty of Humanities but is waiting for a spot in the Faculty of Education. She hopes to become a French elementary school teacher. Holly Tesguy. Holly is an Ontario scholar and will be studying at the University of Vermont at Fredericton campus. She hopes to become a certified prosthetist.
Holly is the recipient of 6 awards tonight. The first is the Principal's Award for Student Leadership, presented by Charlotte Phillip, awarded to a graduating student in recognition of his or her outstanding leadership while in ENSS proceeding to post-secondary education. Her second award is the Brian Todd Community Service Award presented by Gail Todd, awarded to a graduating student proceeding to post-secondary who demonstrated high academic achievement, made significant contributions to their community as well as the world, and has demonstrated a positive, strong character. Her third award is the OSSDI District 14 Excellence in Education Award presented by Thana Adam. Awarded to a graduating student displaying the qualities of reliability, cooperation, and dependability, and who has made a significant contribution to the school and or community and is proceeding to post-secondary. Fourth is the Trinity St. Andrews United Church Clothing Depot Bursary presented by Cindy Phillip, awarded to graduating student who has shown dedication to the community, civic-mindedness, and has demonstrated an understanding of spiritual tolerance. Next is the Student Government Spirit Award presented by Susie Dornbos, awarded to a student who has made a significant contribution to school spirit and exemplifies our school motto of tradition, excellence, and heart. And lastly, the Community Members Institute Award presented by Sharon Rusk, awarded to a graduating student with the highest combined average in business education courses. It should also be noted that Holly recently represented ENSS at the Canada-wide Science Fair in Ottawa this year, where she earned a bronze medal. Holly's Science Fair project. Her Science Fair project was then selected as the Canadian entry for the Stockholm Junior Water Prize to be held in Stockholm, Sweden in August later this year. Holly's entry is among 30 other countries. Congratulations, Holly, and good luck in Sweden.
Matthew is an Ontario scholar and he is off to Queen's University to study engineering.
Matt is the recipient of the Ross Pearson Award to be presented by Charlotte Phillip. It's awarded to a deserving student living in Northumberland County proceeding to post-secondary education.
Georgie Tolmax. Georgie is an Ontario scholar who is attending the University of New Brunswick's Burlington campus, where she is pursuing a Bachelor of Science in Engineering. She hopes to work in power generation.
Georgie is the recipient of Charlotte's School Dining Services Bursary, presented by Brad Brzee, awarded to a graduating student proceeding to college or university and has made a positive contribution to school life at ENSS. Well done, Georgie.
Amanda Turner. Amanda will be returning to ENSS, but she hopes to go to college to study graphic design. David Turner. David is a specialist in hospital engineering. David is working on an absolute general contract. Cameron Bible. Cameron is going to grow his college in Quinn Van Gurken. Quinn is a specialist high school graduate of the Environmental Studies. He is going to join his Minton campus to become an arborist.
Quinn is the recipient of two awards this evening. The Brighton Clothing Depot Bursary, presented by Karen Mason Nancy Shepherd, which is awarded to a graduating student who is proceeding to college and has shown improvement during his or her years at ENSS. He's also the recipient of the Crammy Horticultural Award to be presented by Barry Wood. This is awarded to a graduating student who is proceeding to a post-secondary program in the field related in any way to horticulture. Congratulations.
Jessica Van Lindel. Jessica is an Ontario scholar and is heading to the University to study psychology and is also enrolled in a teacher education stream. Jeremiah Woodrock. Walton Bowditch. Cassidy is an Ontario scholar that will be studying social work at Carleton University.
Cassidy is the recipient of the York Road Women's Institute Centennial Scholarship presented by Sharon Rusk, awarded to a deserving graduating student receiving from college or university who formerly attended Smithfield Public School. Congratulations.
Bray Wanley. Bray will be entering the World of Work.
Thank you.
the Alpha and Bessie Pister Award, presented by Ann Fowler. It's awarded to a graduating student with a minimum average of 70% proceeding to a post-secondary educational institution.
Joshua Wright. Josh is a child of the future, but they found to be awesome. He was right.
Last but not least!
At this time, we will be honoring any returning graduates who are receiving awards tonight.
Yes. Ethan Kay. Ethan Kay is going to Queen's University to pursue a Bachelor of Arts.
Ethan is receiving the Thompson and Thompson Victory Award to be presented by Paul Hesse. Oh, sorry, I'm
Now we have a prestigious Governor General's Award, and at this time we'd like to call back to the stage Mr. John Fawcett.
Yeah.
This award will be presented by Georgette Davis. The Governor General's Award, this award is presented to the top graduating student in each high school across the country with the highest average in his or her graduating year based on all grade 11 and 12 final marks. John's average for all grade 11 and 12 final marks was 99.2. Thank you,
and again to Chef Delman.
UNGLC.
And thank you to Rick Ramirez and Paul Jago and the Dragon X crew for providing the lights and sound for tonight.
And finally, thank you to the custodians for all of their efforts in preparing the gym for this evening's graduation.
Following tonight's ceremony, there will be a reception for our grads and their families in Gym C. Grads, it's very important that you go to room 207, which is the culinary room, to receive your actual grad package, which includes your diploma.
I think we're supposed to do that.